Evacuated residents spent the day filing into the VFW. They wanted some financial assistance.
And that is where Ann Bowden is tonight as she continues our team coverage with what other evacuees are doing to find relief. Ann?
Well, Rick and Vicki, that evacuation affected about four counties, meaning about 155 homes and businesses were affected, and the people living inside, about 142, were evacuated. And right now, those people are just trying to make the best of it. Now, we went to one of the Red Cross shelters earlier this afternoon, and several evacuated residents came here to Muldraw Elementary last night to seek shelter and get some food and bedding free of charge. But even their travel expenses will be paid by P&L Railways, as you were mentioning earlier, if they make that claim. Now, residents at the shelter could play basketball. Games were provided for children and adults. Even a makeshift animal shelter was created for the people who were coming in with their animals. One of the back classrooms of the school was made into a makeshift animal shelter. And evacuated residents like Daniel Nall and his family say volunteers here have been pleasant, the food has been very good, and everyone is just, like we said earlier, trying to make the best of it.
This is right up my alley, and I enjoy every bit of it, and helping with the food, the toys, the playing, we play basketball and whatnot.
Now, that was one of the volunteers, and family again says that the cots, they're warm, they're staying dry, so they're glad to have a roof over their heads. Now, the mayor of West Point, Billy Ash, did come to the school to make sure his residents, most of them are West Point, from West Point, the evacuees, trying to make sure everyone is being treated well, they're getting what they need, and if they have any questions. So he was there trying to make sure his residents were A-OK. And as far as the timeline, when residents can return to their homes, no one has that right now, Rick and Vicki, but they can say with assurance that they will return when it's safe. Reporting live here at the VFW, Ann Bowden, WLKY News.